Yeah.
Wow. All right.
Yeah.
Good morning, dear children.
Morning. Morning.
How are you doing?
Mm-hmm.
Amazing. My name is Teacher Josh.
And my name is Jamaica.
I'm Shoshalme.
And I'm Teacher Asha.
And we are so happy and glad to be with you this Sunday morning in our Sunday school class.
Yeah, but before we go on so far, let us pray. Father, we thank you and we bless your name. We thank you for this wonderful morning. Thank you for your blessings. Thank you for your grace upon our lives. For sure, we have seen your face, King of all glory, in our lives. We just want to thank you, King of all glory, for this time as we bring your word to your children, Lord. We pray that you will protect them, that you will fill them with your spirit, Lord, that you will help them to understand and to get, King of all glory, whatever we say. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray, believing and trusting.
Amen.
Amen and amen.
Amen.
Yes, and also to the parents, we want to thank you very much for letting your kids to tune in. May the Lord bless you.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We also want to thank the church leadership for allowing us to teach the children. May the Lord bless you.
Amen.
Remember, even as you tune in, remember to subscribe and like the page. You can also share this message to other kids out there so that this message may reach far and beyond.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
All right. So make sure you share. Press the like button down there below and also subscribe.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah, so today we are having a different kind of a story, but it's amazing. It's going to be amazing, super, super wonderful.
Yeah.
But before we do anything much, as we head for our breakfast, we are going to the
memory bus section.
All right. Howdy. Breakfast.
Hello, my name is Moses. She said in the verse, Psalms chapter 51, verse 7, it says, clean me with hyssop and I will be clean. Wash me and I will be whiter than snow. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Hatha Patrick. I'm going to say the verse. Psalms chapter 51, verse 7, it says, cleanse me with hyssop and I will be clean. Watch me, and I will be whiter than snow. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Rodney. Here's my memory verse for this week. Psalms chapter 51, verse 7. Cleanse the hippest, and I will be clean. Wash me, and I will be whiter than snow. Amen.
Hi, praise the Lord again. My name is Gladys and Daloma. I found memory verse, which comes from the book of Psalms 51 to 7. It says, cleanse me up with thy soap and I will be clean. Wash me and I will be white than snow. Thank you.
Hello, I'm Keisha and I have a memory verse. Psalms 51 verse 7. And it says, cleanse me with thy soap and I shall be clean. Wash me and I shall be whiter than snow. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Colin. So I'm setting the verse. Psalms chapter 51 verse 7. It says, purge me with hyssop, I shall be clean. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. Thank you.
Hi, praise God again. My name is Immaculate Andrew Mwangi, and I'm reciting the verse. It comes from the book of Psalms chapter 51 verse 7, and it says, cleanse me with hyssop, and I will be clean. Wash me, and I will be whiter than snow. Thank you.
I'm going to tell you Psalms chapter 57. It says, renew my skin when I be clean, wash me when I be wet and snow.
Then
oh
my!
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. This is amazing.
Wow.
Yeah. All right. So, hello there, children.
Hi.
Hi.
Yes. Thank you so much to everyone of you who sent in your memory verses. We're really, really grateful and thankful for what you've done. Amen.
Yeah.
Amen. Well, today we want to talk about a story I think most of you do not know about it. Maybe you've never read about it. It's still on Peter. But looking at the disciples and what happened one particular day, just after Jesus had died and risen.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So I think we can go to our Bibles, get to see that story and and learn something from it.
Yeah.
So let's go to our Bibles. We're going to start with Teacher Mike, and then we'll finish at Shashamit. And we're going to read the book of John, chapter 21, from verse 1 all the way to verse
19.
All right, let's go to Teacher Mike.
Verse 1 to 5, it says, afterward, Jesus appeared again to his disciples by the Sea of Galilee. It happened this way. Simon Peter, Thomas, Nathanael from Cana in Galilee, the sons of Zebedee, and two other disciples were together. I'm going out to fish, Simon Peter told them. And they said, well, we'll go with you. So they went out and got into the boat. But that night they caught nothing. Early in the morning, Jesus stood on the shore, but the disciples did not realize that it was Jesus. He called out to them, friends, haven't you any fish? No, they answered.
He said, throw the net off the right side of the boat and see what happens. They did what he said. All of a sudden, there were so many fish in it, they weren't strong enough to pull it in. Then the disciple Jesus loved said to Peter, it's the master. When Simon Peter realized that it was the master, he threw on some clothes, for he was stripped for work, and dove into the sea. The other disciples came in by boat, for they weren't far from land, 100 yards or so, pulling along the net full of fish. When they got out of the boat, they saw a fire laid with fish and bread cooking on it. Jesus said, bring some of the fish you've caught.
So Simon Peter climbed back into the boat and dragged the net ashore. It was full of large fish, 153, but even with so many, the net was not torn. Jesus said to them, come and have breakfast. None of the disciples dared asked him, who are you? They knew it was the Lord. Jesus came, took the bread and gave it to them, and did the same with the fish. This was now the third time Jesus appeared to his disciples after he was raised from the dead.
Verse 15, when they had finished eating, Jesus said to Simon Peter, Simon, son of John, do you love me more than this? Yes, Lord, he said, you know that I love you. Jesus said, feed my lambs. Again, Jesus said, Simon, son of John, do you love me? He answered, yes, Lord, you know that I love you. Jesus said, take care of my sheep. The third time he said to him, Simon, son of John, do you love me? Peter was hurt because Jesus asked him the third time, do you love me? He said, Lord, you know all things. You know that I love you. Jesus said, feed my sheep. Very truly I tell you, when you were younger, you dressed yourself and went where you wanted. But when you are old, you will stretch out your hands and someone else will dress you and lead you where you do not want to go. Jesus said this to indicate the kind of death by which Peter would glorify God. Then he said to him, follow me.
Yes, that is what happened. I love this story, guys.
Yeah. It's quite interesting.
Yes, anytime I read about it, I'm so excited seeing how Peter was, he didn't have any clothes on him. But when he saw and realized that this is Jesus, man, he jumped into the water and swam.
Yeah.
He even left the boat. I really love that aspect.
Yeah.
Mm. Yes. So I think we can draw a few points from this story, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, we can start with Shammai.
The most interesting part of this story is in verse 2. Simon Peter, Thomas, also known as Didymus, Nathanael from Cana in Galilee, the sons of Zebedee, and two other disciples were together. We can see even in trying times, we can see even when their master was not there, they were together, they came together. They were there for each other, I can say that.
Yeah.
I think that's a very good point.
Yeah, true.
Yeah, even in hard times, when times we feel as if we have lost someone or something, we need to be careful to stay together and find fellowship in one another.
Yeah.
Don't stay away from the fellowship.
Uh-huh.
Yes, keep the fellowship.
Yeah.
I even like the aspect when Peter said, I want to go fishing. The other disciples said, yeah, we'll go together with you.
Yeah,
you don't have to go alone. We'll go together with you.
Yeah.
So I think even for us children, we can stick together and walk together, work together, embrace each other and do a good job together.
Yeah.
Right?
True.
Yes, yes. Another point?
Well, another thing we see from that portion of scripture, Jesus is a miracle worker and he's a provider.
Yeah.
You know? We see that Jesus came, they found him on the shore, and he had prepared breakfast for them.
Mm-hmm.
You can imagine having Jesus prepare breakfast for you.
Yeah.
Must be fascinating.
Yeah.
You know what, if this breakfast you're waiting to have,
mm-hmm.
what if Jesus was the one in the kitchen?
Hey, yeah, my friend, huh? I can't imagine what kind of breakfast that would
be.
Yeah,
it would be awesome.
Yeah,
yes.
So Jesus is a provider whereby he is able to provide
mm-hmm.
to our needs.
Yeah.
Probably he knew that the disciples were hungry, they were tired from
mm-hmm.
fishing and catching nothing, and he was there to provide them with breakfast. And we see that that provision itself is a miracle.
Yeah.
You know?
Yes.
That is true.
It is a miracle because we are not told that Jesus went out fishing.
Mm-hmm.
Jesus was there, but he had prepared breakfast for them.
Yeah.
So Jesus is a miracle worker.
Yeah.
And we can see, I think we can find very many miracles. You know, Shasha?
Yeah.
I think you must have seen another miracle there.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think also there is a miracle where we see that the disciples had gone out to fish the whole night, but they did not catch any fish, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But Jesus told them to throw their nets in the right side,
mm-hmm.
and their nets were filled with the fish.
Yeah.
Was
you know?
It the right or the left?
The right.
The right.
It was the right side?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, so, and even in that miracle, I also see the aspect of obedience. Because I think if they were, they did not obey what Jesus told them, that they should throw their nets on the right side, instead they do it on the left side, I don't think they could have caught anything.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So I think even in our daily doings, whatever we do, even when we are at home, when our parents tells us something, remember always to obey.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah,
obedience has its own reward.
Yeah.
Like for the disciples, they obeyed Jesus,
mm-hmm.
and
they
got
a lot of fish.
Yeah.
Yeah.
A lot of fish.
So remember, kids, to always obey your parents, your elderlies.
Yeah, so that is a very important point.
Yeah.
We should obey even to the smallest of instructions that God gives us. We should obey them.
Yeah.
Yes.
I
like the aspect
we can say that obedience is a prerequisite for miracles.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Just like faith,
mm-hmm.
yeah.
you know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So
when
faith and obedience go hand in hand in receiving the miracles of Christ.
True.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. True. I agree.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I think something else we can learn is we should always be joyful or happy or even anticipate whenever we know that you're going into the presence of the Lord.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. When Peter saw that this is Jesus, he was super excited and he said, man, I have to go and meet Jesus. You guys, you come later, let me go. I'll go meet Jesus. You know, we should be very excited every time that we know we are going to church,
mm-hmm.
or we are going to fellowship,
mm-hmm.
or we are going to somewhere where we know we will have a good time with the Master.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, so I think it is important, even for us children, whenever you know you're going to church, or to a fellowship, or to a gathering where Jesus is preached, we should always show the excitement and be ready and anxious to meet with Christ.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think that's amazing.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, yes. Teacher Mike?
In the previous class, we saw that Peter denied Jesus. This was after Jesus was crucified, he was buried, then he rose again, then he appeared to his disciples in this story. So I can see that Jesus loved everyone in every circumstances, but we can see that the love of Jesus is exceedingly above all other things. Because Peter denied Jesus, Jesus was not angry. We can see that Jesus continued loving Peter in every situation.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think Jesus called Peter aside and he asked him, Peter, do you love me? And he did it three times.
Yeah.
Yes.
I think in the asking three times, it was to nullify the denial of Peter three times.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. The fact that Peter denied him three times, Jesus had to confirm the same three times by asking him, Peter, do you love me?
Mm-hmm.
Peter, do you love me?
Mm-hmm.
Then feed my sheep.
Yeah.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think we should love and also know that Jesus loves us.
Yeah.
Yeah.
True.
Yes. His love is like the way we say, your love is higher than the mountains.
Mm-hmm.
You know? His love covers our sins, a multitude of sins.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
And I think in Jesus' love, we can see that there's a task that comes with accepting to love Jesus. You don't just say that I love Jesus, but I'm doing nothing about it. There's an expectation from Jesus towards you. You see, like the way he told Peter, when Peter said, yes, I love you, told him, feed my sheep. So I cannot love Jesus and do nothing for him. If I love Jesus, I ought to show his love through the way I treat other people, through how I bring other people into the kingdom.
Mm-hmm.
So as children, when you say that you love Christ, what are you doing for Christ? Don't just say, I love Christ, but you're not telling your friends about Christ.
Yeah.
You're not spreading the gospel. Mm-hmm. You're not telling other people about this Christ who you love. You
yeah.
ought to tell people about Christ if you really love him.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, so the aspect of feeding the sheep.
Yes.
Yeah.
Right?
Uh-huh.
And he even demonstrated it by doing breakfast for them.
Yeah.
I think with love, there's a lot to do with how you express it to others.
Yes.
Yeah.
So you love Jesus by showing it to others.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Not to your only yourself, but to others.
Yes.
Yes.
So I think as we conclude our class, one of the things we can also learn from this is that we need to be discernful.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we should discern when Jesus is around. I think those are the major lessons we can learn for this class. Yes, but remember, the biggest lesson to learn here is love.
Yeah.
Yes, but also there's also the aspect of discipleship.
Mm-hmm.
Mm.
Jesus asked them, just when they had finished eating, that what you do now, come follow me. And they went with him, right?
Yeah.
So with that, we can go to our memory verse for next week, then we'll be done with the class.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, and for our next week's memory verse comes from the book of 1 John, chapter 4, verse number 7. And it says, dear friends, let us love one another, for love comes from God. Everyone who loves has been born of God and knows God. Yeah, so that's our memory verse for next week. 1 John chapter 4, verse number 7. Remember to read the verse, memorize it, take a video of yourself reciting it, send it to the numbers on your screen. We receive them and we'll showcase them in our next class.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yes. Thank you so much, Chasha, for the memory verse.
Yes.
So remember, 1 John chapter 4, verse 7. Now, last week we gave you two challenges. One, you had to tell us the difference between betrayal and denial.
Yeah.
We also asked you to sing a particular song. We thank you so much for those you've sent in. But let's go and see what you guys did.
Betray to say something about somebody.
Forgive one another. This is what we should do. Forgive one another. Even as God has forgiven you. Even as God has forgiven you. 70 times 7. We should forgive one another. Forgive one another. This is what we should do. Forgive one another. Even as God has forgiven you. Even as God has forgiven you. Thank you.
Forgive one another. This is what we should do. Forgive one another, even as God has forgiven you. 70 times 7, we should forgive one another. Sisters and brothers loving each other, we should forgive one another. Forgive one another, this is what we should do. Forgive one another, even as God has forgiven you. Always forgiving, always forgetting, ready to make a new start. Loving each other with all of our hearts, we should forgive one another. Forgive one another, this is what we should do. Forgive.
Yes, thank you so much to all of you who sent in your challenge. May the Lord bless you.
Yeah.
But just so that we give the answer to the question on denial and betrayal, denial is a statement that something is not true. Whereas betrayal is going behind someone's back or selling them out.
Yeah.
All right? Just like Peter did, Peter denied. He said that, I don't know Jesus, whereas the truth is, he knew Jesus. But Judas betrayed Jesus. He went behind his back and sold him. So that is the difference between denial and betrayal. But remember, both can be taken as sin. Yes, now we are done with our class. But before we go, we would like to sing a song and pray.
Yeah.
As we wait for our breakfast.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Yeah. We could stand up, sing a song.
Yeah.
Then we'll be done. Yep.
Before we sing, let us pray. Our dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for the class you have given us. We thank you, Lord, that you have enabled us to see the end of this class, O Lord. Oh, Lord, we thank you for the kids that have been there since we started, and now we have ended this class. Oh, Lord, we ask, Lord, the Lord may bless them, O Lord. Oh, Lord, even as we finish the class, O Lord, oh, Lord, we ask, Lord, the Lord may bless us and continue blessing us, O Lord. And it is in Jesus' name I believe. Amen.
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 Thank you.
Amen. Thank you, Teacher Mike. All right. That song, let it come.
Yeah.
Jesus love is very, very wonderful. Jesus love is very, very wonderful. Jesus love is very, very wonderful. So wonderful love. So high that you can't get over it. So low that you can't get under it. So wide that you can't get around it. So wonderful love.
Bye.
Right. Bye-bye, children.
Bye.
See you in our next class.
Breakfast.
God bless you.
Breakfast.
Time for breakfast. Yeah.
Woo.
Where's the waiter?
Yeah.
Waiter.
Waiter.
Food.